Anna sat watching the road on which her son was to come. When she saw him coming, she explained to his father, "Tobit, your son is coming, and the man who traveled with him." Raphael said to Tobiah before he reached his father, "I am certain that his eyes will be opened." "Smear the fish gall on them. This medicine will make the cataract shrink and peel off from his eyes. Then your father will again be able to see the light of day." Then Anna ran up to her son, threw her arms around him, and said to him, "Now that I have seen you again, son, I am ready to die." And she sobbed aloud. Tobit got up and stumbled out through the courtyard gate. Tobiah went up to him with the fish gall in his hand, and holding him firmly, blew into his eyes. "Courage, father," he said. Next, he smeared the medicine on his eyes, and it made them smart. Then, beginning at the corners of Tobit's eyes, Tobiah used both hands to peel off the cataracts. When Tobit saw his son, he threw his arms around him and wept. He exclaimed, "I can see you, son, the light of my eyes." Then he said, "Blessed be God, and praise be his great name, and blessed be all his holy angels. May his holy name be praised throughout all the ages, because it was he who scourged me, and it is he who has had mercy on me. Behold, I now see my son Tobiah." Then Tobit went back in, rejoicing and praising God with full voice for everything that had happened. Tobiah told his father that the Lord God had granted him a successful journey, that he had brought him back the money, and that he had married Rigel, his daughter Sarah, who would arrive shortly, for she was approaching the gate of Nineveh. Tobit and Anna rejoiced and went out to the gate of Nineveh to meet their daughter-in-law. When the people of Nineveh saw Tobit walking along briskly, with no one leading him by the hand, they were amazed. Before them all, Tobit proclaimed how God had mercifully restored sight to his eyes. When Tobit reached Sarah, the wife of his son Tobiah, he greeted her, "Welcome, my daughter. Blessed be your God for bringing you to us, daughter. Blessed is your father, and blessed is my son Tobiah, and blessed are you, daughter. Welcome to your home with blessing and joy. Come in, daughter." That day there was joy for all the Jews who lived in Nineveh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: praise the Lord, our soul.
Praise the Lord, our soul.
Praise the Lord, my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God while I live.
Praise
the Lord, my soul. The Lord keeps faith forever, secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free.
Praise
the Lord, my soul. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers.
Praise
the Lord, my soul. The fatherless and the widow he sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever. Your God, O Zion, through all generations. Hallelujah.
Praise
the Lord, my soul.
has the same little light. That this kind of great mystery that the one who created David will also be the son of David, the whole wonder of God becoming a human being. And they don't quite understand it, but it delights them. That's the way that the word of the Lord should hit us. That it's something so great that we can't quite fully understand it, and that's why it's so great. That if we could fully understand it and comprehend it, it would be just a human thing. And that would be fine. But this is something beyond that. This is something that we get a glimpse of kind of how true and great it is. But just a glimpse, because there's more there to be seen. It's like seeing a giant building or something. You can see part of it, but you have to walk all the way around. And the walking all the way around will be, hopefully, us in eternity, still seeing more, getting to know God better. We've been reading all this week through Tobit. I joked at the beginning of the week that it's summer, so you have more time to read through the book. You don't need to do that, because we basically read through the whole book this week. And this wonderful kind of conclusion where Tobit and his wife, things turn out well, that all through all their trials and troubles, now they have the delight of seeing their son return, and he with a wife, and now there's sort of hope for the future. They can sort of relax. There's this great rejoicing. And Tobit himself will be able now to see his son cure him. It's an interesting kind of foreshadowing of going back to David, that it will be the son of David who will cure David. It's the son of David, Christ himself, who forgives him of his own sins, who will redeem the kingdom that fell into disrepair after him, that will cure the whole of humanity from their sins. So Tobiah becomes a kind of Christ-like figure, even in the beginning. Throughout this whole week, we can see in the book of Tobit that there's a kind of story going on that's bigger than us. It's back to the truth that delights them, that's bigger than them. That the cast of characters in our lives is not just us. It's not just our story. There are other characters involved. Raphael, the archangel, is present throughout this story. Tobit and Tobiah, Sarah, he's sort of working behind the scenes. There's fallen angels working behind the scenes, too. But most of all, there's God himself, the author of the whole story. These characters going about their lives, either cooperate with him or not. And that's us. That we live in a story that's sort of our own making, but really is God's. And that there are other characters involved, archangels, angels, fallen angels, that are part of our story too, working for good or for ill on that sense. So at the end of this story, all turns out well.